thing on top of it, like a lot of people call it a bee, but it's not a bee. Apparently it's a bug.
On the steeple at the top is a flea.
They come round for a collection and no one put into the collection, and the guy whoever put a big louse on top of the church.
Yeah, on the top is a dragon. They all say it's a flea, but it's not a flea, it's a dragon.
Nearly
embarrassed.
I mean, they both love each other.
It's a
normal thing for them to just get together. I mean, it's just
salute. That's all I know about it. It's a bit dilapidated. They've been let go, I think, isn't it?
No, but Juventus has got a good defense. But anyway, just York, and Beckham.
Used to be beautiful when I was young. The stained glass windows behind the altar were like deep colours, like really dark greens, reds, rich yellows, like mustardy yellows, you know?
Not it's history, that is.
Can you see?
No, no, that is.
Oh, that one with the
Halloween.
Clock. Oh, it's so scary.
You burst into conversation. So, that was scary.
That's fine, but how's she going to get in the pool?
I can't believe he did that.
I can't believe it either.
I mean, he told her to tell me to tell him, the other him. She said that he said that he was lying. And he was lying.
Again and again.
What?
Watch this word, it's going to be a bird camp kick.
Oh no, that's my new football. I only got that yesterday.
I didn't mean it. You could tell I didn't mean to kick it over.
Well, you shouldn't have such a big toe then, should you?
I'm going in somewhere and get the ball.
How are you going to get that ball when no one's been in there for years?
Bill, just watch me.
It's impossible.
Look here.
Get on the ball.
Just keep helping me.
It's impossible.
Stupid.
Open up.
Sorry, mate, I really didn't mean to kick over, but you got to admit, it was a good kick, wasn't it?
People have died here.
No, stop being silly.
I'm not being silly.
We're just gonna get the ball and come out.
Welcome to my Church of St. Luke's, Nicholas Hawksmoor, architect at your service. Where you stand was once fen and marshland, but when drained and improved, it was laid out as gardens and orchards. Famous writers like John Milton and John Bunyan came to live here. At the beginning of the 18th century, Parliament passed the 50 New Churches Act, and I won the commission for a splendid new church in Old Street. Although they would not let us spend a penny more than £10,000, it's one of my favourites, and many have praised the singular design of the stone steeple. I've always been fond of obelisks, and the harmony of the parts. It was opened and consecrated on St. Luke's Day, 18th of October 1733, and for 200 years it remained the cynosure and the glory of the area. Not that you would guess at it now. Sadly, it was sited on poor foundations and fell into neglect and ruin. Presently, it brings only shame on its creator and this noble city.
No, that doesn't. Come on, we're going.
No, I've got to find the ball.
Forget the ball, where
to
go? I'm scared.
I've got to find the ball. It's going to be here somewhere. Look, there it is.
How did that just happen? No. Oh, it's got to be here somewhere.
Hello? Is this yours?
Thanks, mate. Is this some sort of a game? Are we on TV or something?
No, you're not. You're in my office. Welcome. Welcome to our beautiful new London Symphony Orchestra Education Centre. What do you think of it?
Terrific.
Well, perhaps it's not brilliant at the moment. But you are a bit early. In fact, you're our very, very first visitors. You see, the LSO has a wonderful education programme, and it's aimed at everybody, old and young alike. Anybody who wants to know more about music. People like you, people in schools. We bring LSO musicians into school. We invent music.
Brilliant.
The children decide what shape the music's going to be.
Think you've stopped, but then
you carry on. It's a great idea. People think you've stopped, but then you carry on again, so we're never quite sure what's going to happen. It's a surprise, yeah.
At the beginning, the night music plays quietly as Sarah trembles on her violin.
Fast as you can. If you do at the top of the bow, it's easier.
We rehearse it together. You'd be amazed how quickly a piece of music goes together when you've got experts like us working with experts like you. We put on special concerts at the Barbican, where the orchestra works, just down the road. And we invite people like you to come and share our concerts with us. We even invite you to play with the orchestra. Can you imagine playing with the world's finest symphony orchestra? Akeem, up you come. You do it. So all you do is that. Boof. Don't break my stick. You don't... Ooh. Hey, Akeem, you've got to be able to stop it as well, so it goes boom and stop. With... Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Hang on 2 seconds. So, down, and then stop with our hand. Here we are. Good, isn't it? Back you go. Now you know why this concert's called Gobsmacked.
As a double bass player, yeah, in the London Symphony Orchestra, it's a good chance to sort of share the enthusiasm, really, of playing in an orchestra.
For the little kids, they just can't believe that this many people sit together and play together, and it's just a big spectacle for them, even though they don't necessarily realise what's going on. And then at primary school, it's important because if we only inspire one kid to take up the clarinet, we've inspired one kid to take up the clarinet.
Children have open minds. If they're left to their own devices, they're creative, they're imaginative, and education should be about gaining access to that. That's what we're trying to do in these concerts. That's what we're trying to do with our St. Luke's project.
Don't start till my stick hits the book. Here we are. And...
the recorder a little bit.
Do you?
And my dad can play nearly anything on the piano.
Is he really good?
Yeah.
Well, our education programme is for people like your dad. And probably your granddad and your grandma. You see, we have special events for everybody.
Farewell the neighing steed and the shrill trump, the spirit-stirring drum, the ear-piercing fife, the royal banner and all quality, pride, pomp and circumstance of glorious war. And oh, you mortal engines whose rude throats the immortal Jove's dead clamors counterfeit.
I find the whole concept of comparing opera and Shakespearean plays on which they're based absolutely fascinating.
The Discovery programme is always excellent. It covers any number of composers and it's always extremely well arranged. Very good speakers and very, very interesting.
So I'm totally ignorant and eager to learn and will lap up anything that analyses a major work of art.
We like both the play and the opera. And also because we have a great love for Jose Cura.
I think that music is one of the great inventions of the human mind. It's not for nothing that children are supposed to do better if they listen to Mozart. Cows do better, and certainly I do better. After that enormous noise we made yesterday, I went home and listened to a Mozart piano concerto. And then I thought, well, God was once in his heaven. The beauty of St. Luke's is that it will not only bring music to young people, but it will bring music to people of all ages. And how do we know that it will provide one of the greatest interests and comforts for older people, perhaps those who are disabled and so on? They will find a new live interest in all this. So we hope that the youngsters will grow up loving music, and the old ones will also discover that this is the greatest comfort that has yet been invented on this planet.
Metallica were pretty loud.
You thought that was loud? They weren't even trying.
So, what do you need this place for?
Well, that's a very good question. As you can see here, we've got at the Barbican Centre a wonderful home for all our concert giving. But unfortunately, because the Barbican Centre is so successful in every way, they have very little time or space for us to develop our education programme here. We looked for many, many months to try and find a place that might be a suitable home for the LSO education programme. And it was interesting because the minute we set eyes on St. Luke's, all of us thought, this is it. I mean, it is such a beautiful building, just in terms of scale and scope, it's ideal, it's near the Barbican Centre. But I think almost the most important thing is the building has a magic of its own. And it's interesting because ever since that first day when we decided this was where the home of the education programme should be, this excitement and commitment has actually grabbed every single person who has come to see St. Luke's.
Clive, do the orchestra only play classical music?
Great music can mean classical music, it can mean film music, it can mean pop music. I mean, we've been involved in many of the greatest films of all time. For instance, all the Star Wars, Raiders of the Lost Ark, Superman, all of these films. In fact, we've just done the music now for The Phantom Menace, the new Star Wars film, as well as Notting Hill. And I can tell you that the orchestra's players, they love that sort of work just as much as great classical music.
Thank you.
One, two, three. That's better.
Be with us.
That was wicked. But this place, it's a bit of a dump.
A bit of a dump? Yeah, I suppose it is really. But it's not going to be. Look, here are the plans. It's going to be fantastic. Here's the auditorium. That's where we do the concerts and the workshops. Oh, underneath there's going to be a wonderful restaurant. And then we've got a gamelan room and we've got workshop spaces. You can... I suppose it is a bit difficult to imagine, isn't it? Look, I'll show you something. Close your eyes, hold tight, off we go.
That beats Alton Towers.
But where are we?
We're in the main auditorium. You see, the orchestra will be here, the audience will be there. You see, we've put a new roof on and we've reinforced the walls. And in here, we'll have workshops, we'll have special concerts, and the orchestra will rehearse, and the whole world will be able to come in and join us.
What do you mean?
Well, you see, the place is going to be very high tech. We'll use the internet. I'll show you what I mean. Look. So you see, St. Luke's is going to be in touch with the whole world.
That's going to cost a few quid.
A few million, actually. You see, we were able to go to the lottery for money after one of the world's great banks decided to help us.
We will commit financial resources only to projects which clearly relate to the fundamental themes of education, music, art, etc., which are important to us, but also which do involve all our colleagues in something positive, something which is tangible to them and tangible to the community in which they operate. With regard to St. Luke, the themes of education and music come together beautifully. Moreover, it does address one issue which will be increasingly important in our consideration, and that is the issue of heritage and of the salvage and redevelopment of important landmarks. It is a new step in its new format and purpose, but one that hopefully the next generation will see as a natural succession to its previous purpose.
Where we're standing will be called the Gerwood Hall. That's because the Gerwood Foundation wanted to help us as well.
Gerwood's about
young people. It's about opportunity, and it's about doing all the things that we believe in. The opportunity of education in a very wide sense, not in a narrow sense about what you have to do at school or what you have to do at university. It's education for life. And I think it's going to be a very special occasion indeed when the first sounds ring out in this Sherwood Hall.
Of course, this is all going to take a couple of years.
Sorry, Richard. I've got to get a bit of my dinner.
Gosh, time does fly, doesn't it? Okay, close your eyes. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, anytime you like. Come back and see us. See how we're getting on. Anytime you like, you're always welcome.
Thank you.
It's a pleasure.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Safe home. Yeah. Come back soon.
Bye-bye.
That was fantastic.
I know, I felt a bit sick when we were flying.
Well, you're travel sick.
Vivi, are you all right? I mean, I was worried about you. What happened?
Where have you been?
Don't even ask. Wouldn't believe me if I told you.
Do you want to have another game of football?
Don't lose it.
Oh, yeah, tell me about that dress.
This is going to be a wonderful project because what it will do is enable the LSO, which is, of course, one of our greatest orchestras, to put in place a lot more in terms of education work, outreach work, taking their work through new technology around the country and giving them a space to rehearse as well. I welcome this project for two reasons, wearing two hats, because of course I'm not only the Secretary of State for Culture, but I'm also the local Member of Parliament. And I'm particularly pleased, of course, that lottery funds from the Heritage Lottery Fund and from the Arts Council are being used to such good effect. It's such a wonderful building, Grade 1 listed building with the most magnificent steeple. And it's in many ways the most wonderful building in my constituency. To see it being brought back into good use, to see it restored to its former glory, that's going to be really exciting.
Whatever is good in its kind ought to be preserved in respect for antiquity, as well as our present advantage. For destruction can be profitable to none but such as live by it.